56. Browns nothing. Chris Boswell to kick off for Pittsburgh.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded right around the 8. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
Browns take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Browns offense trotting back onto the field. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across. Midfield.
A 28-yard gain. First down.
Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Mayfield to throw it. And the ball is knocked out. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And they will set up shop at their own 46-yard line.
On the play. Recovered.
Well, Parker, I think it's safe to say they can mark this down as extremely frustrating. Here we are in the fourth quarter, and that last play, that turnover, I think it epitomizes what happened to them all day on offense.
So symbolic, and that's why they're still being shut out. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they have to be feeling pretty good. Comfortable fourth quarter lead as they take over following the fumble recovery. Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver. And it's second down.
Juju Smith-Schuster.
And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and take him to like turtle at this point. You just go ahead and play.
Juju Smith-Schuster, the intended receiver that time. And that'll bring up second down. Coming up on the final 2.5 minutes. And boy, has it been fun to watch this offense operate. Quite the display, and now they look to polish it off.
And his throw here is incomplete.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way and worked out.
It doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
And not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now, here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
The pass.
The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Brings up third and
he just clocked it, but the clock wasn't even moving. Well, that's one you don't see very often, a wasted down. So the snap will come from the 3, but remember, they don't need the touchdown. They can get the first down, and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. They seemingly just continue to score at will, and as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
I love that you use the word will. because both teams came into the game with the will to win. But one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ball game. I know we could sit up here and dance around it a little bit, but going for two in this situation, somebody doesn't like someone else. There's no doubt in my mind.
Well, what they couldn't see is you lean back in your chair and you went, that's not a good decision. They didn't get it, though.
Yeah, I don't think you just say, well, my kicker's hurt in this spot.
No.
No, okay.
First down, Mayfield. And finding the tight end, Hooper.
Mayfield's pass.
A gain of six there on first. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. And the Steeler pressured too much here. He's going down. Devin Bush came in there hard on the blitz and got him down 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, head into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Minka Fitzpatrick. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. Yet another mistake after the interception there. And, gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Tackle made back at the 44-yard line.
The Steelers are AFC champs once again, as we say thanks for watching and good night. And that will do it for this one. For Charles Davis, myself, and the entire crew, we'll see you in 2 weeks at the Super Bowl.